comme on va. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're talking about aquatic marine scent, and I saw what would be the best to film an aquatic marine scent is in Brittany, which is my hometown. So I didn't choose the best day because it's not gonna rain. Like in Brittany, it's like that in the morning, and then after it's very sunny. So we'll see how it goes. But I look like a weirdo, like literally, like if there's someone, like it's in the morning, so I don't think there will be anyone today. But like seeing someone speaking in English with a camera in the middle of the rocks, I mean, all right. Please subscribe to my channel. There's just a little button in here. Oh my god, really the catastrophe. If you want to see my face more often, activate the little bell and you will know when I'm launching a new video. Also, sorry for the light today. I mean, the weather is quite changing, so sorry about that. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram if you want to see more of my posts every day and a little bit about my life as well. So in today's video, I'm talking to you about true marine scent. So when I'm talking about marine scent, I'm talking about not just an aquatic note inside a fragrance, something that really makes you feel like you're by the sea and next to the sea. Especially if you're like me, like coming from the coast and you're living in the capital now, like London or Paris or whatever, and you're missing your coast, you're missing the sea, the seaweed, like, you know, type of smell and everything like that, and you miss that saltiness. This is kind of fragrance that you won't wear every day possibly, but something you will enjoy to wear because it reminds you of something. So I've done a quite like a nicely blend of that, and I hope you're gonna enjoy as much as I enjoy those fragrances. First one I wanted to talk about is called Wood Sage and Sea Salt from Jo Malone, and this is definitely my favorite because it's a fragrance that is easily to wear every day. You can wear that as normal, it's not too salty, you know. But it's got like a very true elegance inside. It smells like sea hair, it's a mineral texture, literally. It smells like the sand, the stones, but without being too natural. It's something that you could wear as a nice, elegant scent as well. What I like about this scent is it's pure simplicity and elegance, and it's got a slight woody base that gives like a little touch of sophistication to the scent. You've got also like a scent like seaweed inside and salty notes, of course, to give that vibe like you're by the sea and just enjoying the saltiness of the air. So I didn't classify them as top one to top five. So these are generally five fragrances that I enjoy when I need my kind of marine scents. But this one, Wood Sage and Sea Salt, is always my favorite. And every time, like even just when I'm having a walk in London, like having a little bit of this fragrance is lovely. The second fragrance I want to talk about is a fragrance for male, but it's something that I quite enjoy sometimes to wear as well. And it's a scent that is not a pure marine scent, like I explained in the beginning, but it's got an accord that makes me think of the cleanness and freshness of the marine sea. And it's Allure Homme Sport from Chanel. And I wanted to talk about this one because, of course, like it's a very sporty but casual chic fragrance, I would say. And but it's got an ingredient inside that is will be described as the salty notes for you, or maybe like a marine note, probably on Fragrantica or something. But it's actually a crystal clear accord, and a crystal clear accord is created by a molecule that is called dihydromyrcenol. And this molecule by itself, when you smell it, smells literally like you've been putting your clothes in the washing machine, and it's really clean scent. So that is really the marine scent that I can smell here. I can smell more seaweed, but anyway. But yeah, it's really that idea of a clean freshness. Mandarin and orange to balance it and to give you like a bit more of sunny vibe, sporty vibe, without being too sharp, which is delicious, I think. And compared to the other one, this one's got like a quite like a warm base with tonka bean and vanilla, but very discreet. It's really more on the citrus that you will smell and on this marine scent that you will smell. So when you're pretty active, this fragrance is delicious for daytime or something like this. Also, it's really an idea of translucent. When I smell it, I smell something very luminous, you know, something that won't be too heady or things like that. So I think it's quite nice for daytime and just to remind you of the pure hair. It's basically, if I give like, in my top five, if I give like a description for this fragrance, I would say it's the tuxedo of the marine scent. And also, it's been created by Jacques Polch, which is one of my favorite perfumers. If you didn't see my video about Jacques Polch, please have a look, because it's really an interesting man. My third one is quite surprising as well, because it's a fragrance by Annie Goutal, and it's Les Colognes Vetiver. So it's not the EDP version, but really Les Colognes. And it's quite funny, because if you look at the description online, you will probably see that there's some spicy notes and vetiver, of course. But really, when you smell it, you smell like a sharpened vetiver at the beginning, and then you really smell like a saltiness to it. So I don't know what's inside, but really, it really makes me think of something very, very marine. So it's such a beautiful scent, actually, when you want to feel that kind of like coast type of scent. So nice, there's birds that are doing like a... They're flying in lines. Maybe you're going to see that at the camera. Yeah, beautiful. It's really like an aquatic scent, even though you've got that very earthy dry down. It really like feels very aquatic. It's probably like more like a silk dress, like I would say, because it's quite velvety, it's quite sharp and quite light. But if you want something that is sophisticated, if you like vetiver and you want something like a saltiness but not too strong, this is lovely. Except probably this one's got a bit more sensitivity. I've read also some comments that say, oh, but it doesn't stay, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, but, yeah, of course, like, I mean, it's a cologne. If you want nothing that stays, you will take the eau de parfum. But it's a cologne. And a cologne, the definition of it is it's here to make you, to refresh you, not to stick to your skin all day and be like quite warm. It's here to refresh you. But I feel for me, it's a very romantic fragrance, and I do really like that. It's really poetic. So yeah. For my fourth one, we're gonna go to a bit more strong character, because we're gonna go to Tom Ford, one of my favorite designer. Can we call it designer? Well, whatever. It's from the Aqualine, and this one is not one of my favorite, but I do really appreciate this fragrance. I do wear it sometimes, but very occasionally, so it's not like... But if I'm talking about marine and aquatic scent, I'm always thinking about this one. So it's Costa Azura by Tom Ford. So you've got celery seed, oud, some cardamom, and seaweeds, of course. That's why it smells so salty and marine. And it's got a little bit of greenness, but this one, I would say, is a bit more deeper than the other one. Like, it's more woody, more sharper. In the wood. Got also some incense, so it's got that DNA of Tom Ford, which is quite mysterious vibe, you know, like very sensual, but with a lot of mineral notes. So sometimes people compare it to oud mineral as well, which I say, like, why not? But this one is a bit like more, I would say, hairy for me. Also, it's got something a bit greener, because you've got juniper, and I feel that it's something that really reminds me of the coast. Well, at least my type of coast, because as you can see, like, it's all green over there. It's quite herby, it's got that saltiness, it's aromatic, so it's really like a different vibe from the other one. I would say much more character for sure, and if you want to assume a very aquatic scent, this one is not something that is quiet, it's loud. But it's definitely something a bit more sunny, and that's why I do appreciate this scent so much. The fifth position is, I didn't want to do like a top five of marine scent without something that smells actually very marine. And if you don't know this, I would say like have a try, because if you really like a marine scent, a proper aquatic scent, this is the definition of it. It's James Healy, and it's sel marin. You've got a bit of green notes in there, so it's quite earthy, but of course, like when you buy the sea, it's always smell a bit green. And you've got also some lemon and bergamot to remind you a bit like of a uplifting sunny side. A heart that is moist, seagrass, seawater and salt. And this is crazy, like really the smell of seawater is really like, I don't know how to explain it, like you really smell the liquid with a bit of saltiness. Smells very, compared to the other one, very oceanic. It smells windy, it smells like you're in a boat and you're just a sailor across the sea and you're smelling that. Some people say also that it's a bit the lighter brother of Oud Minéral from Tom Ford, which I'm like, probably yes, but this one is it's more hairy, it smells more like the place I'm right now. Really. If you miss your seaside, just like sometimes I do miss my seaside, you're probably gonna enjoy that. It's not something I would wear every day, not at all for sure, but it's some type of scent that would remind you something, give you like a good memories or something, so it would be quite nice. This is not the best seat I had. I hope you did enjoy the video. Please comment which is your favorite marine scent and what do you enjoy to actually make you feel that you are in the real Brittany. Just after that, I'm gonna show you some little video of where I am right now. But it's really cool. It makes me really happy. I need a bit of a quiet holiday. So like for me being here, it's so nice. So like you see, it's the morning, so usually in winter in Brittany in the morning it's very like foggy like this and not very sunny, but then in the afternoon it will be sunny again and beautiful as always. And we've got like, as you can tell, like I've got like a very like marine type of coat, but it's not that cold to be honest, compared to London for sure. And in the afternoon we'll be okay, like it's not that cold in Brittany. We have a little microclimate because what you can see here is not the Atlantic Ocean for sure. So yeah, and I think over there there's the little island over there, it's so cool. But yeah, I'm gonna stop this video and enjoy my little Brittany. I hope you're having a good start of 2020 and I will see you soon. Bye now.